since the DMK has pulled out, is it at this stage?
It's nothing to do with the DMK raising it or DMK pulling out. Question is, should the sentiments and the anguish of the Tamil people be reflected in a resolution? That's the question.
It was articulated even in the Congress President's address to the Congress Parliamentary Party yesterday, which has been reflected in the statement.
हमें डीएमके के लिए ये रेजोल्यूशन की बात नहीं है कि डीएमके ने सपोर्ट विड्रॉ कर ली तो इसलिए रेजोल्यूशन नहीं आएगा. कल से जब मैं दूसरी सब राजनीतिक दलों से चर्चा कर रहा था, मैंने उनसे ये बात कही थी कि ये डीएमके के कारण नहीं है, ये अलायंस के कारण नहीं है. ये है कि तमिल भावनाओं को देखते हुए क्या हमें ऐसा प्रस्ताव लाना चाहिए, और अगर लाएं तो किस प्रकार का होए. तो ये बात डीएमके से जुड़ी हुई नहीं है
जी. मेरा एक सवाल है,
I think you're bringing in unnecessary issues. I will only use the word unnecessary. We are discussing a serious issue, the issue of the views of 8 crore Tamil people, which is being expressed in various ways, including demonstrations and protests by students. And I do not think it's fair to bring in other issues into the issue that is now under discussion, namely the Sri Lanka issue.
Yes, please.
Sir, just Sanjay, please. Yes. Let's give somebody else a chance.
After the withdrawal of support by DMK, sir, how comfortable government will be to forward its legislative agenda in the parliament, particularly there on reforms like land acquisition bill, food security bill, or FDI in insurance and the pension sector? And a hypothetical question, will you favor early polls in case you fail to push your legislative agenda?
No. Only yesterday we passed a very, very important bill, the Criminal Law Amendment Bill, only yesterday. And today I'm confident that the Rajya Sabha will return the appropriation bill, and the Jharkhand budget will be returned by the Rajya Sabha. We have a legislative agenda lined up. The Minister of Parliamentary Affairs has legislative business for the next couple of days. All these bills are necessary for the country. All these bills are necessary to take the economy forward. And I'm sure on the merits of each bill, there will be enough political parties who will come forward to support the government and pass the bills. We have no doubt that each one of these bills stands on its own merit and will be passed on its own merit.
Aditi, please. Just 1 minute. I'm coming to Aditi. Aditi, please.
Samudrika government also are suggesting that perhaps the timing of the DMK is suspect, given that the voting in the UNHRC is only on the 22nd of March. So why now? So many questioning whether this is just getting ready for early elections, given that some of your allies have pulled out and some who are still there, whether outside the government as well, are asserting themselves more.
That's not correct. That's not correct at all. That's all I can say very briefly.
Minister,
देखिए, सहयोगी को सरकार में लाने का अभी प्रश्न नहीं उठा है. अगर कोई आना चाहेंगे हम चर्चा करेंगे, पर ये जो आपने छवि की बात करी, इमेज की बात करी, ये भी सही नहीं है, क्योंकि छवि सरकार के कार्यों से होती है, सरकार की नियत और नीति से होती है, और इसकी पहचान आम जनता में है. तो हमें इस बात की कि इमेज खराब हो रही है क्योंकि डीएमके चली गई, डीएमके ने सपोर्ट विड्रॉ कर ली, मैं नहीं मानता इसका कोई संबंध है.
Mr. Chidambaram, I have a question about the what my colleague asked in a slightly different way. You are now on more crutches than you were previously, and a person on more crutches is usually more weak. So I'm just wondering if, and foreign investors and others are also asking us and others, whether the appetite for reform in government is now dulled, not just through the legislative route, but also the, you know, you yourself said that FDI caps are going to be increased in some sectors. There are going to be other things that you're going to do. it's true that you have a numerical majority, but you don't, I mean, you are weaker than you were previously.
This is a wrong perception. Government functions through making laws as well as through executive action. The division between making laws and executive action is quite clear in the Constitution. Now, we are in government. We have a duty to steer the ship, even if there is a mild storm in the sea. And we have our hand firmly on the wheel. We will continue to take decisions. We will continue to push for legislation. Only yesterday, the cabinet cleared the food security bill. Now, if you think that the government is weak, do you think we could have pushed the food security bill yesterday? The bill will be introduced in Parliament, and I'm absolutely confident, as I said to an earlier question, there'll be enough support in Parliament to pass each bill, because each of these bills stands on its own merit and deserves to be passed on its own merit. As far as executive action is concerned, only this morning, the ministers approved disinvestment in SAIL. So we are taking executive action. We are pushing bills. I don't see us as any weaker today than what we were yesterday. Yes, it is true. One ally has withdrawn support. But as my colleague said, the government enjoys a majority, and the government will continue to do its duty. The government will continue to take executive action, and the government will continue to push for legislation in Parliament.